Hello everyone, welcome to anujindal.in. So in this video I am going to discuss the syllabus of management in detail for the purpose of SEBI grade examination 2021-22. So friends, the objective of this video is to make you aware with the syllabus so that you can prepare on your own if you want to, okay? And also this video is beneficial for the enrolled students because they will get an insight into what all is covered in our course. So let's start. So as per the last year notification of SEBI, the syllabus of management which was given is management, its nature, scope, management processes, the five process: planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, then role of a manager in an organization, leadership, the task of a leader, leadership styles, leadership theories, a successful leader versus an effective leader. Then HRD, human resource development, concept of HRD and goals of HRD. Then after that, motivation, morale and incentives. So theories of motivation, how managers motivate, concept of morale, factors determining morale, role of incentives. Okay. Then communication, steps in the communication process, communication channels, oral versus written communication, verbal versus non-verbal. Then upward, downward and lateral communication, barriers to communication and role of IT. So this is the syllabus which is given in the notification, but I will discuss the syllabus in detail. Okay. So first of all, management, the introduction about management, what is meaning of management, then nature, okay, the scope and the processes or functions, the five functions: planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Okay, you can remember this abbreviation. Okay. Then responsibilities of manager. So there are different responsibilities of manager. Okay. Then levels of management: top level, middle level and lower level of management. Then types of managers. So managers can also be classified into different categories. Then managerial roles by Henry Mintzberg. So Henry Mintzberg identified 10 managerial roles and grouped them into three categories. Okay. Then management skills. So basically there are three types of skills: conceptual, technical and people skills. Then organization theory, OT, and types. So there are different types of basically there are six theories. Classical, first one is classical theory. So classical theory is you can say given by many people like Taylor, Henry Fayol, Weber. Okay. So Taylor's theory is called theory of scientific management, very very important. Henry Fayol is known as the father of general management and he gave the 14 principles. Then Max Weber gave the theory of ideal bureaucracy. Basically, he propagated that the ideal form of running the organization is bureaucracy. Okay. Then human relations approach. Next, first was classical approach. Next is human relations approach. So basically, Elton Mayo contributed to human relations approach through the experiments known as Hawthorne experiments. These are also very very important. Then next comes behavioral science approach. This uses fields of study like psychology, sociology, anthropology. Okay. Then next is social system approach. So basically this approach talks about interaction between social groups. Okay. Interaction between the different social groups, and Chester Bernard majorly contributed to this approach. Then next is modern organization theory, which is an improvement over previous theories. So modern organization theory is integrative and it integrates formal and informal both organization structures. It says that both are important. Then finally, the last one is contingency approach, which says that situation or environment plays a major role. Okay. So Edwards Deming theory is there. Then theory of constraints, Burns and Stoker's theory. So these are some theories under contingency approach. Then also Mooney and Reilly and M.P. Follett's, their theories are also important. Then after that comes organization structures. Okay. So this is a part of organization function. So there are five functions like planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Okay. So organization structures come under this second function of organizing. Okay. So there can be different types of structures like traditional, modern, flat versus tall. So under traditional models or under traditional structures, you have functional structure. Okay. you have line structure, you have line and staff, whereas under modern structure you have project structure, okay, you have matrix structure, you have boundaryless organizations, okay. Then some other concepts are work specialization, which means division of labor. Then chain of command. Chain of command says that there should be only one boss for one employee. Okay, so an employee should get orders from only one superior, not from multiple superiors. Okay, otherwise he will be confused. Then span of control. Span of control means how many subordinates are there under one manager. Okay, this is called span of control. And then there is a theory also, and under this theory there is a formula to calculate the span of control. Then centralization versus decentralization. Again, these are very, very important terms. And a related term to this is delegation of authority. Delegation of responsibility, delegation of authority. Okay, this is also important. Then next is organization goals. So mission, vision, strategy, goals and objectives. These are five terms. And you should know the difference between all these five. Mission, vision, strategy, goals and objectives. Okay. Then goal succession, goal distortion, goal congruence, goal displacement. Again, very, very important terms. But you just need to know the meaning of these terms. You don't need to go into detail. Okay. Then what is the meaning of organizational effectiveness and how to achieve organizational effectiveness? Then, as I told you, planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So controlling is the last function. So what you need to study under controlling? First of all, the steps. So there are some steps, or there is a process of controlling. Then nature. Okay. So controlling, what is the nature of controlling? Then difference between controlling and planning. Okay, how these two are different and how these two are related to each other. Then benefits of effective control system. Limitations. So one of the limitation is that it is the expensive process. Then management by exception. So management by exception, MBE, it is also called control by exception. It means that only significant deviations should be brought to the attention of managers. Okay. Small deviations should not be brought to the attention of management. Then kinds of control, tools of control. So there are different types of control, like feedback control, concurrent control, feed forward control. Then tools of control are budgets, ratios. Okay. Then employees' reaction to controls. So generally employees do not like controls because they find themselves that they are too much supervised, or that they are too much, you know, controlled. So they don't like controls. Then next is leadership. Very, very important. So under leadership, what you need to study? First of all, the difference between a leader and a manager. Okay. There is a basic difference between leader and manager. Then informal versus formal leader. Styles of leadership. So there are different styles of leadership, like autocratic, democratic, okay, free reign. Then Likert's management system and leadership. So Likert's also gave four styles of leadership. Then great man theory. So according to great man theory, leaders are born, they are not made. Okay. Then trait theory says that a leader has some characteristics or some traits. Okay. So if a person do not have those traits, then he cannot become a leader. Then continuum of leadership. Again, this theory was given by Tannenbaum and Schmidt. Okay, this is also very, very important. Then some behavioral theories like Michigan studies, Ohio State leadership studies, managerial grid. Okay, so most of these studies, they study two aspects. One is the task behavior and one is the relationship behavior. Okay, so these two factors are studied by most of these theories. Then next comes situational theory, which is, you can also say, contingency theory. So it says that leadership, there is no one best style of leadership. The style of leadership depends upon the situation. So Fiedler's contingency model, Hershey and Blanchard model, path goal theory, these are some of the important situational theories which you have to study. Then next is difference between a successful and an effective leader. Difference between transactional and transformational leader. So a transformational leader has a charisma due to which people follow him. Okay. Then leader member exchange theory, LMX. This is also called LMX theory. Okay. Then French and Raven's five forms of power. So they talk about different forms of power like coercive power, reward power, position power, okay? Then Bass transformational theory, then directing function. So the five functions, as I told you, planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So under directing function, there are what you need to study: supervision, leadership, motivation and communication. Okay, supervision, leadership, motivation and communication. Communication we will see in the upcoming slide. Leadership we are studying, okay? Then motivation we will also study in the upcoming slides. And now we will study supervision. So supervision, what is supervision and what is the meaning of a supervisor? Then characteristics of supervisor, importance of directing, okay? What is the importance of directing function? Then who is a supervisor, what is the role of a supervisor, and what are the functions performed by a supervisor. Okay, now moving on, these are some other models: Vroom, Yetton, Jago decision model, Coos and Posner model, Heckman four styles of management, Gordon Alport trait theory, Adair's action centered theory, and 10 fatal leadership flaws, Zenger and Folkman. Although these are not very important, but again, we cannot leave anything because we don't know what may be asked in the examination. So I have mentioned them. Okay. Then next is human resource management and human resource development. Okay. So this is the staffing function, planning, organizing, staffing. So now we have come to staffing function. Okay. So what is human resource? So human resource basically means KSA, knowledge, skills, and abilities. Okay. Then what is the meaning of human resource management? Then Elton Mayo, okay, he is the father of human relations approach, okay. So the Hawthorne experiments are very important. Then human resource management, and what is the difference between human resource management and personnel management? Then functions of an HR manager. So basically the functions of an HR manager can be divided into managerial functions and operational functions. So under managerial functions, he has to perform the functions of planning, organizing, directing and controlling. And under operational functions, he performs functions such as procuring human resource, okay, training them, okay, giving them compensation. So all these functions are performed by human resource manager. Then evolution, nature and objectives of human resource management, HRM models. Then what is strategic HRM? So basically strategic HRM is concerned with integrating the goals of the organization with the human resource function. So integrating these two. Then planning function, HR planning. Okay, HR planning is basically concerned with that what is the current inventory of human resource and how many human resource we require, how many more people we require. Okay, then recruitment. Okay, so there are external sources of recruitment and internal sources of recruitment, and then there is selection, final selection. And there is an entire process of selection, okay, very important. And you need to study the difference between recruitment and selection, okay. Then induction versus orientation. So when a new employee joins an organization, then there is an induction program so that the employee is made aware of the organization, the working of the organization, and he is made aware, or he is, you can say, made friends with the other employees. Then movement of personnel. So movement of personnel basically means retirement of employees, or you can say promotion, okay, promotions, retirement, transfer, separation, okay. Then employee turnover, very important, which is also called your attrition rate, okay. So employee turnover and types of turnover. Then training and development. So training and development is very important for employees, because you need to continuously train and develop your employees. So under training and development, you have to study what is training, okay, what is development, and what is the difference between training and development. Then there is on the job training, okay, on the job training methods, and there is off the job training. So all the methods of on the job and off the job, they are very important from exam point of view. Then Kirkpatrick model. So this is a model for calculating training effectiveness, that how effective was the training. Okay. Then next is organizational development, OD. Okay, so under OD there are different interventions which are taken to change the culture of the organization. Then career planning and development. So under career planning and development, there are many important terms like career path. What is a career path? What is career anchor? Okay, what is career planning? What is career goals? So these all important terms you have to study. Career planning, succession planning, career development, then management development. So again, in management development, you have on the job and off the job. Then what is HR accounting? What is HR audit? What is human resource development? Okay, characteristics and emergence. Then relation and difference between HRM and HRD. Okay, then functions of human resource development. So training and development, career development and organization development. These three are the functions of HRD and we have already discussed. Then what is the goal of HRD? Okay, and how HRD has evolved. So many concepts were there before HRD. So the evolution of HRD. Then after that comes motivation, morale and incentives. Okay, so meaning of definition, meaning of motivation. Then we will discuss different theories of motivation like Maslow theory. Okay, so Maslow theory gave 5 types of needs, Maslow hierarchy. Then theory X and theory Y, given by McGregor. Okay, then motivation hygiene theory. So as per the motivation hygiene theory, it is also called two factor theory. Motivation hygiene theory is also called two factor theory. So under this theory, there are two factors. One is the hygiene factors and one are the motivations. Then McClellan theory of needs. So he gave 3 types of needs. Then Elderfer ERG model. So E stands for existence, R stands for relatedness and G stands for growth. Okay. Then next is self-determination theory. So this theory says that employees, they value more on their intrinsic motivation. So if they are given extrinsic rewards for doing something which they like, then their motivation will reduce. Okay, then Vroom's expectancy theory, it is based on valence, expectancy and instrumentality. Okay, so valence, so basically he gives a formula to calculate the expectancy, instrumentality. So there is a formula to calculate Vroom's expectancy. Then Porter and Lawler's expectancy model. So Vroom's model and their model are somehow related to each other. Okay, then next is equity theory. This says that if employee feels that he is not treated equally with other employees, then he will be demotivated. Okay, then goal setting theory. This theory states that employees or managers should be involved in the goal setting process. Okay, then management by objectives, again this is also related to goal setting theory only, that there should be a participative decision making. Then reinforcement theory, this was given by B.F. Skinner. So reinforcement theory was given by B.F. Skinner. Okay, then social learning theory, which says that people learn from imitation or from observation. People also learn through observation. Okay, then self-efficacy theory. So this theory tells about a person's belief in his or her own abilities. Okay, then job enrichment and job enlargement. So job enrichment, if I talk about enrichment, it is concerned with the vertical loading, which means making the job more challenging, whereas job enlargement, it means horizontal loading, which means adding more task to a given job so that the job does not become monotonous. Okay, then carrot and stick approach. Okay, then cognitive evaluation theory. After that, there are some other theories as well, like Hull's reduction theory, Hackman and Oldham job characteristic model, Argyris theory of motivation, this is important. Then three-dimensional theory of attribution. Then Uchi's theory Z, which is a Japanese concept. Okay. Then meaning of morale. What is morale? Okay. So morale is the willingness to work. Okay. Then features of morale. Then factors affecting employee morale. So there are different factors which affects the morale of employees. Okay. Then impact of morale on behavior of individual. So if the morale is high, then there will be increase in the productivity and there will be more profits for the organization. Then connection between morale and productivity and difference between motivation and morale. So morale is a group concept, whereas motivation is an individual concept. This is one of the differences between the two. Then meaning of incentives. So incentive is anything which is given over and above the basic salary to you can say encourage the employees to perform better and to increase their productivity. Okay. And need of incentives. Then types of incentives. So incentive can be monetary. There can be monetary incentive or there can be non-monetary incentives. Okay. You can say financial incentive or non-financial incentive. Then wage incentive plans, there can be individual plans, there can be group plans, and individual plans can be classified based on time and based on productivity. So like there are different types of plans like given in the based on time also and based on productivity also. Then after that you have communication, the function of communication, meaning of communication, nature and characteristics. Okay. So then objectives, process and principle. So the process of communication is important. So first of all there is a sender. Okay. Then he sends the message. So he has to decode, he has to what we say encrypt the message or encode the message. Okay. Then the message goes through the communication channel and it goes to the receiver. Now receiver, he will decode the message, and after decoding the message he will give the feedback to the sender. So this is the whole communication process. Okay. Then types. So communication can be classified on the basis of communication channel. So on the basis of communication channel it can be verbal and non-verbal. So in verbal you have oral and you have written. Okay. Then based on direction of flow you have formal communication and informal communication, and based on number of participants there is different types of communication like intrapersonal, interpersonal, intra-group, inter-group. Okay. So these are the three types of classifications. Then what are the various barriers to communication? So semantic barrier, or you can say language barrier. Okay. Then you have psychological barrier. Then you have organizational barrier. So there are different types of barriers to communication and there are various ways to overcome them. Then tools of effective communication. So there are 4 S of effective communication and 7 C's of effective communication. Okay. Then classroom communication. Okay. And what are the barriers to classroom communication? Then communication models. And finally, what is telecommunication? So basics about telecommunication. Then moving on. So these are some other important topics which are not explicitly mentioned in the syllabus. But again, you must know the basics of these concepts because examiner may ask, because these are related to your OB, OT and management. Okay. So values, features, importance, types. Okay. So there are types of values like instrumental values, terminal values. Okay. Then attitude, what are the components of attitude? Functions, what is the meaning of cognitive dissonance? Then transaction analysis, Johari window. What is emotion? Emotional intelligence. And how to manage emotions. Then personality, determinants of personality, development of personality. So there are two approaches. Then Chris Argyris, immaturity, maturity theory. This is important because this also comes under motivation. Then models of personality, Myers-Briggs model, Big Five model. Okay. Self-concept theory, socialization theory, Carl Jung's theory. Then after that, you have perception, factors which are affecting perception, then attribution theory, perceptual process, perceptual distortions, what is bounded rationality, it is also called limited rationality, then perceptual defense, then decision making, the process of decision making, so there are various steps, then programmed versus unprogrammed decisions, then creativity and innovation and creativity process, then vertical thinking versus lateral thinking. So what is the meaning of vertical thinking? What is the meaning of lateral thinking? Very, very important. There is also a concept called out of box thinking. Okay. Then techniques of decision making. So there are different techniques of decision making like decision tree. Then you have techniques like simulation analysis. Okay. there are different methods, quantitative as well as qualitative methods or techniques. Then errors in decision making, so various biases in decision making. Then six thinking hats model, okay. Then after that, group dynamics, types of groups, theories of group formation, what is quality circle, stages of group development, what is group thing, what is group shift. Then organizational change, okay, how to manage the change in the organization, because generally employees resist change, okay. Then what is force field analysis, then change cycles, Grainer's stages of growth, models of change, and action research. Then conflict, types of conflict, how to handle conflict, okay. Then the process of conflict, negotiation and bargaining. Then authority, what is the meaning of authority, types of authority, and what are the sources to gain authority in an organization. Then power, what are the sources of power and what are the tactics to gain power. Then after that, stress. So what are the sources of stress, symptoms, consequences, what is burnout, this is very very common in organizations, burnout. Then stress management, then learning and the various theories of learning, okay. Then OB mod, this is also important topic. Then organization culture, characteristics, types, importance of organization culture, the changing culture, what is open door policy, what are the models of organization culture, what is Octopace, okay, and what is organization climate and how it is different from organization culture. Then job design, job evaluation, job analysis, job performance. Now this is performance appraisal and potential appraisal. So there is a difference between potential appraisal and performance appraisal. Then what are fringe benefits, determination of wages, okay, and theories of compensation. Then after that, quality of work life, okay, collective bargaining, employee welfare theories, employee counseling, industrial relations. So industrial relation is itself a very big subject, okay. So you just need to study the basics. Then grievance handling, how to handle the grievances of employees, and the disciplinary action. So these are the important topics for the syllabus of management. So I hope, friends, you must have liked this video, as I have tried to cover the syllabus in as much depth as possible. You won't get this much depth anywhere else. So friends, I will be coming up with more such videos. So if you like this video, do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon. All the very best. Have a nice day.